house destroyed, a family left with nothing.
This all happened in Newton, and our Emily Price tonight shows us the frantic race to just get out of the house. Emily?
A mother and her children were sound asleep early Monday morning. The father was at work when all of a sudden a neighbor saw flames shooting through the roof and called 911.
We were asleep and I didn't even hear the door get knocked down.
First thing I saw was the police officers pulling me out of bed.
A cop came into my room and he shined the flashlight in my face. I'm like, oh my gosh.
Smoke was coming into my room and my alarm clock started flashing and they're just like, get out of the house now. And so I ran downstairs as fast as I could.
He's like, your house is on fire. You guys need to get out as fast as you can.
You turn the corner and you see all the lights and you could see smoke for blocks and blocks and blocks. I was driving through smoke getting up there. And
they stood outside for hours and watched their house burn.
I just see the fire start coming up the back side of the house and I'm just like, that's terrible.
All you see is flames coming out of the roof of my room. And
firefighters say Brock Kirby was 1 minute away from fire engulfing his room.
Once we were out across the street by the police cruisers, we saw the fire on the roof.
Firefighters say the fire started in the attic, and while they investigated what started the fire, they say they may never know what caused it.
The damage was so severe that they don't know that we'll ever know. It's just devastating. All of our memories and everything that we've worked for and all of our children's things are just a pile of rubble.
The dining room, bedrooms, kitchen are all charred. They salvaged only a few pictures from a sun porch.
They literally got drug out in their pajamas and some of them in their underwear, so they lost everything that was in the house. I think it's probably harder to walk through after and see the remains of everything in your whole life just gone. It's devastating and we're very overwhelmed with everything and just taken one day at a time.
The house is quite old, so firefighters believe old wiring could possibly be to blame, but again, they may never know why it started. Luckily, the house was insured.
As we heard him say, Emily, you say that they got out with just a few pictures and nothing more. Obviously, they need some stuff to help get them through all this.
They do. They need clothes more than anything. There are six children in all, and of course, the two parents. If you would like to help them, please call 641-781-1797. That number is also on our free website, KCCI.com.
Emily, thanks.